And our next email brings us on to ticks. Karen from Dunleary has a dog with ticks on board. Two ticks she found on, and she's wondering what to do. She's heard old wives' tale about burning them with the butt of a cigarette and that. So, Carl, what do you suggest and what do you do?
Well, Paul, what we do in Barks and Bubbles is probably a little bit on the old side, but we cover them in oil. And
it's like a vegetable oil or something.
Yeah, vegetable oil. It causes no harm to the skin or irritation, and basically smothers the tick. And in that smothering, it releases its grip on the skin.
Great.
And can be safely removed. The issue is if you don't release the tick by whatever means, the old wives' tale burning or whatever, you can pull the body of the tick off, leaving the claws in place, and that can cause a problem, and that'll be down to your end of things.
Yeah, every now and then you'll see like a small little pustule in the skin, and it's just as a result of a tick's body or head and claws not stuck in the tick in the skin. Good. And I mean, that obviously brings us on then to mites and fleas, which you would probably come across a bit in the salon.
Really, mites and fleas would be, there's a cycle, you can tell us about the cycle that they take, but they manifest themselves in an actual flea on the hair. And in those situations, we would obviously brush them thoroughly, removing the living mite or flea. But then you give treatments and what have you on them.
Yeah, there are various products which will prevent and treat for fleas and mites, and they'll also do worms as well. And that's something to bear in mind, because you're also worming the dog as well. But the likes of Advocate or Stronghold are excellent products, and they're applied about every 4 to 6 weeks, and they'll prevent fleas, mites, and
But there's a life
well.
Cycle in that, Paul, isn't there?
There's a life cycle in the flea, which is approximately a month. So even though you see a flea on the dog, it's not that flea that you're worried about. It's the other 90% that are, like 5% of the flea population, let's say, in an environment, be that a house or whatever, 5% are you see on the body. So it's the eggs that the fleas are laying.
And they inject that egg into the skin, don't they?
They lay the eggs in, say, the bedding or the wherever, if there's a particular room or the kennel or that, in the crevices. So now Advocate and Stronghold will actually affect the environment as well, but there are products such as Acclaim, and there are other products where you can spray, say, a kennel or a bed with, and it will kill the larvae, the young larvae that are developing.
Well, in the salon, what we do if we find an infected dog, we sterilize the area, because obviously you bring another dog into that area.
Yeah, absolutely.
If there's an egg on the in the vicinity, you'll reinfect.
It would really be serious for us as well. I mean, if the dog with fleas comes in, but particularly in you guys, you're treating the hair all the time. Well, that brings us back to the health and maintenance of your dog, and it's something that happens quite a lot with most veterinary practices, and particularly my own, where people would have brought their dog to me as a result of being with the groomers, and the groomers would have said, your dog's got an ear problem, anal glands, or he's coughing, or, you know, that's quite common. And so really, it's almost like having a paramedic looking at your dog. So you'd see that a good bit, and I know you and yourself.
Well, I guess we would see a dog for a greater period of time, and any one instance, a groom might take anything from 2 to 4 hours, depending on the size of the dog and the mental mindset of the dog. And a couple of weeks ago, I sent a dog along to you, who was out exercising, a collie, and I was running up the mountains, and the client brought him in for a groom, and said, oh, he swallowed a fly or was chewing on a stick up the mountains, and he's coughing. And well, this raised alarm bells, because kennel cough, extremely contagious. You can tell us about the ins and outs of it, but client didn't know what to do. You know, the recognition of it is somewhat, well, the dog is coughing intermittently. But I recommend that he talk to you and...
He came over to me, all right, and it was kennel cough. Kennel cough is usually got in, let's say, areas of a large concentration of dogs. But like the flu, you can get it just when you're out walking in the street, or that, you know.
That's it from Pet Talk TV today. Hope you enjoyed the show. Any queries or questions, please email them to paul@paulkellyvet.com.